Welcome back to ajspeller.com. In today's tutorial, we're going to talk about divisibility rules. Divisibility rules are important because they help you with operations like multiplication and division. They're used to help you simplify fractions, helps you find other equivalent fractions, used in tasks like prime factorization. So there are a number of reasons why it's important that you know what your divisibility rules are. Let's begin with the number one. Well, all numbers can be divided by 1, and that really doesn't help you in simplification, but just know that all numbers can be divided by 1. The next divisor I want to talk about is going to be the number 2. All right, if the divisor is 2, we know that all even numbers can be divided by 2. The way you tell if a number is even is if you have a 0, a 2, a 4, a 6, or 8 in the ones place. Examples of that would be, let's say we had the number, examples would be like the number 2, the numbers 14, the number 108. If you look at the ones place, there's a 2, ones place a number 4, the ones place a number 8. The next divisor we're going to talk about is going to be the number 3. All right, the number 3, what you would do there is you would take the sum of the digits, and the sum of the digits must be a multiple of 3. Or if you're skip counting, you would hit that number. Examples would be, let's say we had the number 45. What we do is we add the digits, we'd have a 4 plus 5. Well, 4 plus 5 gives us 9, and if we skip count 3, 6, 9, that tells us 45 is divisible by 9. Another example would be 102. Well, that's going to be 1 plus 0 plus 2, which gives us a 3. And again, if we skip count, we would end up saying 3 the first time. So we know that 102 is also can also be divided by the number 3. The next divisor I want to talk about is going to be the number 4. To tell if 4 can be divided into a number, you look at the last two digits. All right, so the last two digits of the number have to be a multiple of 4. Whoops, let's fix that. Have to be a multiple. Whoops, let's come back here. The last digits of the number have to be a multiple of 4. So for example, let's say we had the numbers 9936. Well, 36 can be divided by 4. If we had the number 116, 16 can be divided by 4. If we have the number 64, that can also be divided by 4. The next number we're going to talk about is the number 5. All right, if our divisor, let's get this in the right place. If our divisor is 5, well, we should know that if we have a 0 or a 5 in the ones place, then we know that we can divide that number by 5. And if we look at a couple of examples, let's say we have the number 100. Let's say we have the number 1,245. Again, if we look at the ones place, we see a 0 and we see a 5. So we know that those numbers there can be divided by 5. The next divisor we want to look at is the number 6. With the number 6, we're looking to see if the number can be divided by 2 and 3. So I'm going to say divisible by the divisors 2 and 3. So basically, if it's an even number and if the digits add up to 9, I'm sorry, if the digits add up to a multiple of 3, then we know the number can be divided by 6. And examples of those would be, let's say the number 36, because 6 plus 3 plus 6 will give me 9, and the number ends with a 6 in the ones place. So both of those rules match, so we know that we can divide the number by 6. The divisibility rule for 7 we're going to skip. That's a pretty complicated rule. I'll save that as an exercise to look up online. Next divisor is going to be 8. To know if a number can be divided by 8, we need to look at the last three digits. So if the last three digits are a multiple of 8, then we know it can be divided by 8. Alright, an example here would be, let's say we had the number 16. Well, it only has two digits. It's understood to have a 0 in front. Well, we know that 8 can go into 16, so we know that 16 is, it can be divided by 8. Another example would be 320. Again, 8 goes into 32, and then we tack on the 0. The next divisor we're going to look at is going to be the number 9. All right, for the number 9, it's a rule that's similar to the divisor of 3. Here we're looking at the sum of the digits being a multiple of 9. And let's take a look at a couple of examples. Let's say we have the number 135. So let's do this here, 135. Well, that's really going to be 1 plus 3 plus 5. Well, 1 plus 3 gives me 4, and 4 plus 5 gives me 9. So again, if I skip count by 9s, I say 9, so that means 135 can be divided by 9. Another example would be 81. Well, 8 plus 1 also gives me 9. And again, if I skip count by 9s, I'll get to that number. Next example we're going to look at is the number 10. And this here should also be an easy one. 10, if we have a 0 in the ones place, then we know that the number can be divided by 10. And examples here would be like the numbers 2000, the number 140, the number, I don't know, 6 million. We see that we have zeros in the ones place, so all those numbers can be divided by 10. And the last divisibility rule we're going to look at here is going to be the number 12. All right, with the number 12, this here has a rule that's similar to the rule for 6, but this time it has to be divisible by the numbers 3 and 4, or divisible by the divisors 3 and 4. And let's take a look at an example. Let's say we have the number, let's do 144. Well, if I add the digits up, I have 1 plus 4 plus another 4. Well, that gives me 9, so that means it can be divided by 3. And the rule for 4 says if the last two digits have to be a multiple of 4. Let me fix this up here. So it's the last two digits. So if I look at these last two digits here of 44, well, I know that 4 can go into 44 11 times. So this here passes. So I know that 144 can also be divided by 12. All right, that sums up this tutorial by ajspeller.com on divisibility rules. And as always, thank you for watching.